Sometimes it's impossible to separate the company from the founder. Mark Zuckerberg and Facebook, Steve Jobs and Apple, Elon Musk and Tesla. And for better or worse,
it's hard to see anyone thinking about Uber without quickly thinking about, you know, Travis Kalanick. But that's not always a good thing for the company.
That's Eric Newcomer.
I cover Uber and startups for Bloomberg.
Kalanick has become a lightning rod of controversy in the tech industry over the past few years. And Seth Meyers said he's what happens when you
spray Axe body spray into a suit until it became sentient.
And after a number of damaging scandals, Kalanick resigned as CEO from a $69 billion brainchild. This is the story of how Travis Kalanick built one of the most successful and controversial tech companies in the world. In 1976 in Los Angeles, he attended UCLA to study engineering, and he also started his first company, an online file exchange service called Scour, with some of his UCLA classmates. Months before graduating, he dropped out to work on Scour full-time.
It was back in sort of the Napster days, and it was sort of a failed effort.
Scour ended up getting sued by almost every major entertainment label to the tune of $250 billion, and the company went into Chapter 11. Undaunted, he started another company
called RedSwoosh,
which was another peer-to-peer file sharing service.
The company Acme bought it for $19 million, which was obviously a nice success for Travis, but I think from his perspective, he didn't build the empire that he'd hoped to.
Flush with cash after selling RedSwoosh, Kalanick was looking to make his next move. The story goes he was in Paris with his friend Garrett Camp, who had founded social site StumbleUpon, and they started talking about
this idea of calling a car with the push of a button.
He started Uber, originally called Uber Cab, in 2009, and was first thought of as a luxury service.
It was a black car business in the beginning. It wasn't this sort of peer-to-peer ride-sharing. It was, you know, nice black cars, and this was meant to get a car whenever they wanted and to get a nice car.
But when its main competitor entered the marketplace in 2012, Uber had to pivot.
Once it was obvious that Lyft was going to be successful and be able to do this peer-to-peer ride-sharing business, he was savvy enough to launch his own products.
So Kalanick, well known as an extremely strong salesperson, raised a huge amount of money.
They raised, you know, hundreds of millions from Google Ventures and TPG.
And created Uber X,
which is really the defining product, which lets people sign up with basically the car they have without having to have been this legacy black car worker.
Almost single-handedly, Kalanick created what we now call the gig economy, paying independent contractors through an app for a service, whether it's cleaning a home, delivering food, or being a chauffeur.
Even though the company is 12,000 people now, he very much has a reputation for trying to sort of cut through bureaucracy and keep it like a startup.
But Kalanick has also been criticized for a number of incidents.
The Uber incident comes up sort of so often.
In a 2014 GQ profile of Kalanick, he referred to his company as Boober because of his increased success with women as the CEO of Uber. Then the PR missteps kept coming. In just the first 3 months of 2017 alone, there were enough gaffes, leaked videos, and negative headlines that could easily sink a company.
They blame everything in their life on somebody else.
There's this constant clamor for him to grow up. The company is sort of in the middle of trying to decide whether he can really be their identity, both publicly and internally.
In February of 2017, the board hired former Attorney General Eric Holder to investigate the company following a bombshell blog post from a former Uber employee accusing the company of systemic sexual misconduct. Several days after Uber released a 13-page report, Kalanick announced he would be taking a leave of absence. A week later, he resigned as CEO. So while the question used to be who will Kalanick hire as his number two, the question now is how the company will successfully navigate the post-Kalanick era.